Hey guys, Mike here, One Go Short Play, and we are playing Captain Planet and the Planeteers for the Sega Mega Drive now. Man, was I disappointed by this game when it came out. For one reason only, really. It's not the Amiga game, which is a gosh darn shame. Please help my Planeteers. See, in the Amiga game, well, I'll show you what this game's like. All the Planeteers are caught, captured. There's the fire dude. She's the water dude. He's hot. I can't remember what she is. Anyway, let's go for the fire dude. Oh, I haven't. I've got someone else. Who's that? Wheeler. Oh, that is Wheeler. Oh, hang on. I thought it was Captain Planet. It's the fire dude? Okay. Right. Anyway, my point is... Ow. Oh, God. I don't know which ones I'm going to fire next. Won't be the green ones. Blue. I see. Red. It's going to be the green one next. Ah, the green ones. Green. Blue next. Shoot the robots. Shoot the robots. Okay, this is a different game. The point is, this is a different game to the Amiga game. On the Amiga version... Oh, really? Just getting my head around it. On the Amiga version, you use all the different Planeteers. I want to do that level again. Red first, isn't it? Yeah, there it goes. Okay. So avoiding green now. Green, blue robot. And now blue. Die, robot, die. He's got fire, he's got fire. Hang on, I've got fire. Red. Green. That was green. What's that there? Blue. Okay, so we can see the pattern there, can't we? There's some kind of. Green. It's a bit rubbish though, isn't it? The Amiga version was ace. Again, a bit rubbish, but great in its rubbishness. Oh, this is silly. Better than this in its rubbishness. This is rubbish because it's rubbish. Let's try a different character. The Amiga version, you use the different characters, and they've all got their own levels, and that fire guy has this awesome level in which you take out a load of baddies. Do like slightly Mario-esque. Oh, I see. We've run out of a slightly Mario-esque platform level. And then, at the end of it, for the last kind of half of the level, you climb into a Planeteer-mobile spaceship thing and go off rescuing polar bears. And then start fixing holes in the ozone layer with, like, your super spaceship powers. And it's awesome. This is terrible. That's a terrible bit of platforming. I mean, really... Oh, that's bad. This is bad. and it was awesome. It was really good. It was kind of ropey again, but it had really gorgeous anime. That's water rising, isn't it? Oh, that's all we need. Can I crawl? Thank goodness for that. I can crawl. How do I climb up above that? That's what we need to know. Oh, this is going to be like a slow drown. Oh, no. I am actually drowning. Oh, I see. Okay, we're there, we've done it. Now let's go up there. Come on, we can do this, whatever your name is. Waterman. Or Heartman. I don't know his name. The Amiga version was much better than this. That's gotta be painful, hasn't it, the clean stuff. Oh, it's not. Cool. I'll take that. You know what? It's not dissimilar to the Amiga version. In that it's got these kind of themed platform levels that kind of change as you progress. You know, your objectives change slightly as you progress. Although this is a bit dull, isn't it? I mean, over and over again. Let's try it that way. Oh yeah, we're getting somewhere now. I see. It's like a repeating pattern. Oh, stop hurting me. Evil mice and cockroaches. It's pretty terrible, I have to say. The Amiga version is much nicer than this. Much smaller sprites on the Amiga. Much better animation on the Amiga. And much more thought. Oh, hello. Has gone through the level designs. I saw that. But it is as random as this is. See the way that you wouldn't think you can interact with until you accidentally jump into it. And then suddenly you can. That's kind of how the Amiga version works as well. You're like, one minute you're like, what, you know, where am I meant to go? And then the next thing is, there's like this random bit of background in there that you didn't know you could interact with. and only by accident you've kind of fallen into it bum first, and suddenly something's happening, and there's a kind of a bit of that going on in the Amiga, right? Although it is much better than this, it has to be said. So I see this level loops until you figure that out. That water's probably still coming up at me now, so we'll probably see that in a minute. So let's just try and get over there. And if I go through here and up there, I can probably do that through here, can't I? Come on. Oh, don't kill me. I'm just figuring it out. I'm finally getting there. I'm becoming a master of captaining the planet. Whatever captaining a planet involves. Oh, it is horrible. I don't remember playing this bit though, but I think the bit I remember playing was as Captain Planet. Flying. Like a shooting up. And I'm sure that's here somewhere. But yeah, these charming little bits where you've got these random missions to do and you've got to figure it out just by the backgrounds of the game and what's around you. The Amiga version's a bit like that. That's the only similarity that they've got really though. The Amiga version also has absolutely awesome soundtrack. I see, so that type of pipe you've got to climb on and the other type you can walk on. Okay, I get it now. I have been really ignorant of that. Can't jump though. When you're on those, okay. So it's a crawl under here. Yeah, the Amiga version's prettier, better animated. Those smaller sprites, much better music. And I think also because I got the Amiga version with my Amiga, so again, it gets to pull the nostalgia card. For me, it's pure nostalgia. It's one of the first Amiga games I ever played. And to anyone who's ever owned an Amiga, you'll know what that is worth. Game having been one of your first Amiga games. It was in what, the cartoon classics pack or something? Oh come on, how do I get out of here? Thing is, when you're on that pipe, you can't, when you're on those hanging pipes, you can't jump. So this is frustrating. So I've still got that cold. But these sorts of puzzles, like this, what I'm doing now, this frustrating banging myself around between pipes, was never an issue on the Amiga version. I mean, the levels were very frustrating and very, very difficult. But they also felt a bit more kind of progressive in the design than this. Am I going the right way? I don't trust this game. This game could lead me totally astray. Have I just made that evil rat a good rat? Let's just get out of here. Ow, 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 ow. I'm going this way. I don't care. I don't care what's ahead of me. I stand much better chance of finishing this level just running than I do actually stopping to shoot stuff. Oh no, it's the water. Oh no, and I died. All right, back on Hope Island, there is no hope for the Planeteers because I am done. Captain Planet and the Planeteers and the Sega Mega Drive. Not a patch on the Amiga version, and generally a pretty rubbish game. Thanks for watching.